Assalamu alaikum everybody, welcome to Ami's Kitchen. This morning I'm going to be making Nihari, which is Allah Bakshe, my son's most favorite dish. He would request it and ask me to do Nihari for him all the time. So today I'm at his house and I'm going to be doing Nihari. All you need is four ingredients. You have shank meat here. I have 5 pound and a little bit more shank meat. It looks like this. And you have to have it cut pretty large pieces. Like this is still, my butcher made a mistake in cutting it small, but it's okay. It's still okay. You need 5 pounds. I have 5 pounds of shank meat. I have 1 cup of atta, which is flour. I have 1 cup. This is a Nihari package. Anyone that you desire, whichever company you like, just take it. I bought 2 packages of Nihari masala and I have 1/2 cup of oil. That's the only ingredients I need to make Nihari. So should we start? Let's go. And this is a patila I'm going to make it. Put in my 1/2 cup of oil in there. It's extremely easy. The way I'm teaching you to make this Nihari, it's extremely easy. You can make it. You don't need garlic ginger paste. You don't need yogurt. You don't need anything. But if you, any of you like a recipe to how to make Nihari masala, please let me know in my box and I will teach you that as well. I try to teach I try to teach you guys something that you don't have to do too much of, you know, because not everybody carries all the spices in their homes. So it's difficult to make Nihari masala because it requires a lot of different spices. So this is the best way to do it. Okay, so my oil is hot now. All I'm gonna do is put this masala in. Now, one of the reasons you put this masala in is you're just frying it a little bit in the oil. You have to make sure that it turns dark, like, you know, bhuning it, like, you know, you have to fry it. So see, I'm frying it. Yeah, you see the stove, you can see the heat coming out. So you're just frying it. And look what I did over here with the flour that I had, 1 cup. I put a lot of water in there. See, and I mixed it. See over here, my masala is being fried. Meanwhile, what I did with one cup of flour, I added a lot of water in there. And now it's mixed. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add it in my Nihari masala. Watch. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. You see, just like this. All you have to do, because my meat is not as thick as I usually buy, so I'm not going to put too much water, but I'm going to add a little bit. I'm going to add at least 6-7 cups of water, or 6-7 more cups of water. Okay, now over here I have 7 cups of water. I'm going to put it in, and this is how your salan or your curry should look like. Right now you're gonna see the consistency is very thin, which is okay, because this has to cook for at least, my Nihari turns out very nice because I cook it maximum 5 to 6 hours. Totally up to you. If you want to cook it that long and have it, if you want to have a really good taste of Nihari, you need to give it that much time. So we're gonna wait till it comes to a boil, and then I'm gonna show you how I put the meat in and we'll conclude it. Thank you. Okay, see my curry, it's coming to a boil. So you mix it well like this, and then after you just add on your meat slowly. Don't just dump everything in, otherwise everything will fall on you. So just put the meat in. And remember, it has to cook for 6 hours. So from time to time, 5 to 6 hours. Time to time, you're gonna come and you're gonna wait till it boils first on high heat, then put the heat to medium low and let it cook on a slow speed, and just come from time to time, come and check on it just to shake it a little bit from here to there. And also, because all your flour, once it boils, it comes on your lid, so take all that flour out and put it back in there. Okay, and once it's ready, I will come back and show you once it's ready. Because don't forget, we have to give a baghar on it as well. Baghar means we have to fry the onions, and we have to do that in a ghee, in clarified butter. You see, make sure that everything submerges in there. So when you're making Nihari, always make for 3-4 pounds. Don't make it for 2 pounds or a pound, because Nihari is something you can take it and freeze it. and just take it out afterwards, take it out, put a little bit of fried onions on top with a little bit of clarified butter, and there you go, it's delicious. So once you do this, wait till it boils, you know, rapidly with your on high heat. Once it start boiling the meat, then lower the heat to medium low, okay? And we'll come back when my nihari is 100% ready, and we'll do the bagar, like we'll do the clarified butter and onion in front of you to show you the finished product, okay? Now I'm gonna cover it and I'm gonna wait for it to boil, okay? So there we go. 6 hours later, this is how your nihari should look. Look at this. Now, consistency for my nihari is this. You can have it thicker. You guys remember how thin it was? And take a look at it. All the fat has come out of the meat, and look at the meat. Look how tender the meat is. 6 hours later, meat is tender. If you want to have it a little bit thicker, go right ahead. Now it's time. I'm going to give bagar. So over here, I have my frying pan. It's getting hot. And I took out one onion. I cut one onion and a frying pan. I'm going to fry it. And once I put it, when I put it in, okay, so welcome back, guys. You see the onions here? I fried the onions in ghee. I put four tablespoons of ghee in here, and I had a whole onion. And remember, my meat was 5 pounds and a little bit over. So you take the bagar, you put it in this one, in your nihari like this. And that's what completes your nihari, and the taste will be awesome. You'll see. Don't worry that you didn't put ginger, garlic, or yogurt or anything in there. This is the best recipe of nihari that I have, and the easiest one. So let me take it out in a bowl and I'll get back to you. Okay, everybody, now this is a final look of my nihari. That's how you will serve your family. You can serve it with naan. If you like a handmade roti, you can serve it with handmade roti. But there you go. This is the final look. This is how it is. You can squeeze a lime in there. And I showed you everything. It's very easy. Give it a try. And like I said, if you need me to do a nihari masala, just message me and I'll show you how to do a nihari masala as well. But this is the simplest way to do nihari. And this is how I serve it. Enjoy. Bon appetit from Ammi's Kitchen to your table. Thank you.